Liberals have nasty replacement for nativity scene and have officially gone way too far. This is sick. Twitter recently exploded when liberals replaced the nativity scene with something much different. People walking down this particular street caught a glimpse firsthand at the job done by liberals to replace the nativity with a version sure to make most people cringe. It could be the most strange thing you'll see all day. Of course, that's normal in 2017, which has been widely used by liberals to push their agenda in everyone's face. The liberals spent most of 2017 pushing their often daft agenda in your faces with an in-your-face attitude and approach to force others to accept the lifestyle they live. They've been protesting and doing all sorts of weird things to get people to accept gender changes and sexual preferences, feminism, and other often annoying common senseless approaches to life. That's what wonderfully makes the liberal nativity replacement shocking, but not shocking. It's exactly what you'd expect it to be. Twitter blew up like fireworks on 4th of July when someone posted the gayativity which featured two displays of Joseph and little baby Jesus. In other words, there's two gay Joes and an adopted Jesus sitting front of someone's house. If it's not two Josephs, then some stated it could be Joe and Marty. Either way, there sure wasn't an immaculate conception between two guys who birthed Jesus, that's for sure. Daily Wire reports. Except that would be virtually impossible, because neither Marty nor Joseph could bear a child in their womb. It also wouldn't go over well with Jewish law at the time. Not that any of that matters, since the display simply exists to mock the very idea of Christmas itself, that a virgin birth from a woman's womb could bring about the salvation of the world. It makes sense for the LGBTQ crowd to wave their pom-poms for it. But why the feminists of Refinery 29? Nothing says boys' club quite like two dudes fathering the most influential human being, who's also male, throughout all of history, while women are nowhere to be found. Being gay is okay. Changing religious stories to make characters gay to meet your own personal agenda is not. If Jesus had two gay fathers, then the boy could be adopted and we don't know who his real parents are. Or, God and Mary abandoned Jesus and left him to be adopted. Luckily, in this bizarre world, that means Jesus survived Planned Parenthood. Sure, it's all make-believe when the person replaces the statue of Mary, but it's just another example of people pushing their agenda on others when it's not wanted or asked for. DW mentions feminists cheering for the two guys one Jesus display, then reminds the feminists that there are no women around, which is quite contradictory to feminism. You would think feminists would protest this for removing the only woman in the nativity scene, then demanding little baby Jesus to wear a pink hat and attend the women's march when he's older. Forget being a stud carpenter, this beta boy Jesus could have been bedazzled and marching in pride parades by the time he was 10. Directed in California, the gayativity scene was discovered by queer comedian Cameron Esposito, who quickly posted it to Twitter to say she was beaming at the Christianity mocking scene. The Twitterverse soon followed her lead. I'm beaming too. I think it's hilarious. Two gay Joes hanging out with little adopted Jesus. That's funny, right? We just need some black baby Jesus in there and the setup is perfect. You cannot have a nativity scene without a minority or you're racist. It's 2017, remember? Everything is inclusive or offensive. I can only imagine the three wise men would be transgender at this point. Everything is ruined. Marty must be a transgender man for this to happen. That means she's actually a he, but she's dressed in he clothes and wants to be a he. However, she possibly gave birth to Jesus, unless he's adopted, of course. In fact, Jesus should be Asian because there's a lot of adopted Asian kids in the world. That would make sense for this 2017 gayativity. Exactly. The gayativity is nothing more than a mockery of Christianity. Maybe it's a joke. Maybe it represents the lifestyle of the people who live in the home. I could care less what someone decorates their home with, but it brings up another swell point that's much bigger than the decorations. Why is it constantly okay for the left to mock religion and lifestyles, but no one else is allowed to without being called something that ends in ISD or phobic? That's neither tolerance nor fair. I think transgender people are hilarious and have to think about the backlash whenever I think about cracking a Caitlyn Jenner joke. Back in the day, it was funny to crack jokes about everyone and everything. People had thick skin and could handle humor. Nowadays, most people, particularly the left, cannot fathom a joke that might be 1% offensive. Yet, they go and do things like make Jesus have two gay fathers. If anyone who was moderate to right did anything of the sort, the leftists would have a field day protesting this. What if there was a gay Bible and straight people replaced their nativity scene with straight characters? You'd see a protest, right? Right?